Hi, YouTube. This is Rich Crummel. I'm in Des Moines, Iowa, and we just wanted to introduce you to Bruce. I've been watching a lot of do-it-yourself teardrop trailer builds, and I've learned a lot, and I just thought I'd return the favor. So what we were trying to do here, our goals were to just to try to make something different that hasn't been made before, or at least that I haven't seen. Something that was small enough to fit in my garage, something that was wide enough to put it in a king-size bed, and that has one more feature that teardrop trailers generally don't have, a lot of storage. So, if you want to look at the overall design, this is all built from scratch. It's all tubular frame, all steel, tubular frame walls, aluminum skin on the outside, plywood on the inside, and all finished interior. One little thing that I learned from my dad about trailers was, when we started this trailer, we didn't know where the point of balance would be, so we didn't know what the tongue weight would be. So what we learned was, is if you attach the axles to a separate beam and then bolt that to the main beam, it allows you to move these axles forward and backwards, changing the weight on the tongue and the way that it tracks down the highway. Another little thing that's different about this one, obviously you have two axles instead of just one, gives it a lot smoother ride. Come around to the back. It's a typical teardrop trailer design, although I don't know if we can call it a teardrop because it's a little bit bigger, but I don't know what else to call it. So here we have our outdoor kitchen. We put the doors overhead so that you have a covered area you can do all your cooking from. Have a nice big aluminum cooktop. Everything inside is just kind of modular. It's easy to pull things out. Cooler's removable, the stove is removable, the bins and the pantry items are all removable. Water, we're just using water jugs and all gravity fed, not messing around with any pumps or anything like that because we just don't want to have anything freezing or have any maintenance issues. You have an air conditioner built in, vents through the back, and there's an interior door that opens up to allow you to cool down the inside. This is the great feature about this one is we have a very, very large storage in here. The storage is about 4.5 feet wide, 13 inches tall, and 10 feet deep. We're able to store all of our camping equipment, extra tables, lawn chairs, awnings, all that stuff. Battery is mounted underneath instead of in the front. It just allows us to keep all the electrical items close together. Have a battery cutoff switch here. That isolates the battery from all the other electrical while you're going down the road. And also have a place to hook in shore power so that you run the air conditioner. Have an inverter that'll allow you to run a little bit of AC power and just off the battery in case you wanted to run some, you know, critical piece of camping equipment like a margarita blender. And lastly, we'll show you the inside. Again, we went with overhead doors just because it was a little bit different. It's kind of nice because they're out of the way and they give you a little bit of shade when you're entering, give you a little dry area to get in here. Underneath the flooring here, this is a trap door that allows you access to the interior, storage underneath. That way you put your suitcases, boots, all that, all those kind of things up nice and close, but still out of the way. Switches and power unit up here, pretty typical. We kind of went with a kind of nautical inside of a sailboat kind of a theme for this. Again, this is a king size bed. One other thing I wanted to mention is the outside. The aluminum skin is all applied without rivets, except for the trim pieces on the top and bottom. The aluminum is all applied to the 1-inch tubular steel frames using a 3M VHB tape. It's kind of nice not to have a bunch of extra rivet holes that are prone to leaking sometime in the future. And the aluminum, was difficult to find aluminum sheet large enough for what we wanted to do here. Obviously, we're 17 feet from nose to tail on each side. We're 6.5 feet wide on the top. When I started, aluminum sheets that I could find were only 4x8 sheets. Checked around a bunch of places, and I stumbled across a great source for these, and that is, you go to a semi repair shop. This is the same aluminum that goes on the top of a semi trailer. It comes in coils, so they're easy to transport home. They're 103 inches wide and 54 feet long. More than enough for one small project like this. So we'll have some still pictures of the build after the video. And folks I want to thank on this, obviously I didn't do it all by myself. And my brother for a little engineering advice, and my nephew Caleb, a lot of hands-on help with this. And obviously my wife Brenda, who really helped tremendously in saying yes and helping with financing. Thanks all.
Town on a boat going to Southern Islands, sailing to reach before a following sea. She was making for the trades on the outside and the downhill run to Papeete. Off the wind on this heading live the Marquesas. Got 80 feet of a water line,
nicely making way
in a noisy bar in Avalon.